Here we go. Talked about things percolating.
Thornton is going to go with Georges Laroque. Just seconds into Laroque's first shift in the Canadiens uniform. Thornton puts him down. Laroque gets right back up. Lefty against righty, and they're both connecting. Thornton trying to turn him. Laroque getting in a lot of shots to the back of the head, some forearms to the back of the shoulders. As Thornton turned on the bench, Thornton muscles him on the dash and gets in a short left. Laroque, little taps on the back of the head. But you got to give it to Thornton on the takedown and points.
For penalties called fighting. No shortage of punches thrown between these two heavyweights.
Ellison Maxwell on the faceoff, tipped off the boards but not out, and now we've got a battle started. We got a battle going now. It's going to be Peters and Laroque. We talk about heavyweights. They decided to get it on real early in this game. No sense wasting time as they size one another up and down. While Peters slipped and fell, trying to get back up again, Laroque let him get back up and then knocks him down again.
I'd rather sandpaper a bobcat's rear end in a phone booth than fight Laroque.
He was acknowledged
here, just as we figured the other night it would be Fritz and Cote. That never happened. And now, if either gentleman would be so inclined to throw a punch, we'd actually have a fight.
What a tough first fight in the NHL for Mitch Fritz, though. He was looking forward to it, though.
Well, still nobody's throwing a punch, and now they get going a little bit. Fritz throwing right hands, and now an overhand left. He turns Laroque around. Laroque about as tough as they come in the league, and Mitch Fritz is more than holding his own. He's held Laroque's jersey and twirled him around.
Laroque is known to be the strongest guy in the league, and look at how Fritz is handling him just fine. A great first effort by Mitch Fritz. His first national...
Making a bad play in their own zone and paying a price.
Zdeno Chara is going to go with Georges Laroque. These are two of the biggest players in the league. Laroque does not often punch up. Laroque's listed at 243, but a trainer from Ottawa said that he was told by a trainer in Pittsburgh that he's actually 273. Chara just body slams Laroque.
Crosby. Ferentz on the poke check. Crosby tries to sweep it in front. Whiteman gets a piece. Letang toward the middle of the wrist shot. St. Thomas. And Crosby's in a fight with Ferentz. Crosby getting a couple of rights in. Ferentz comes over the top and gets the takedown.
Bradley goes into the corner and Chara staples him. Erskine is squaring off with Milan Lucic. Erskine's been largely a scratch for the last 3 weeks. Lucic gets in a couple of rights. Erskine trades. Lucic another right. A wild right by Erskine scores. Lucic covering up. Erskine gets his right arm loose and pounds Lucic down.
Chara. Now Brookbank offers. And Brookbank and Lucic are going to go. Brookbank getting a couple of shots in over the top. Is Lucic's first fight since his broken nose. Brookbank throwing some wild rights, hasn't really connected yet. Lucic goes underneath. Nobody's landed a damaging blow as of this moment. Brookbank wild over the top. Lucic can't come underneath. Swings and misses up top. They're just wrestling for position now. Now Brookbank tries the face rake to get Lucic's helmet off, and he does. The sweater won't come up because the fight strap remains fastened. And now Lucic is underneath Brookbank's sweater. Trying to get his right arm loose of the elbow pad, and neither man really can throw a damaging blow. That'll go down as a draw. But Brookbank is doing Walker's housekeeping for him.
Paul, referee Dave Jackson says play on. And now the gloves come down. It's Erskine